Hello everyone, welcome to Lichens of India channel. In this video, I'll be discussing basic questions like what are lichens, how do they look, where do they grow, and what are the different names for these lichens, what is the relationship between the various partners within the lichens. First of all, let us know what are lichens. In simple terms, lichens are nothing but fungus. You know, these fungus, they don't have chlorophyll. They have to depend on other organism or other things for their survival. They have different lifestyle. Like some fungus are saprophytes, they grow on the dead organic matter. Some fungus are parasites, they grow within or they depend on other living organism for their survival. Some are symbionts or some symbiotic. Here in this case of lichens, these fungus are symbiotic. They have made an association with photosynthetic partner, either green alga or cyanobacteria. So once they make this kind of association, so they lose their original identity. That is the beauty of these lichens. So if you simply bring one algae and one fungus together, it is not called as a lichen. So to become a lichen, these two organisms has to undergo morphological and physiological changes. That is why they lose their original identity and behave like a single entity. So that is called lichenization or the lichens. So lichens are nothing but symbiotic association between fungus and a photosynthetic partner, which is green alga or cyanobacteria. So here in this case, these fungus are called as mycobiont, and this photosynthetic partner is called as photobiont. Sometimes people say if it is green alga, they say it as a photobiont, and if it's cyanobacteria, people say it is a cyanobiont. So otherwise, lichens are stable, self-supporting symbiotic association of a fungus and one or more algae or cyanobacteria. So if you see from outside lichen thallus, it is fungus only. And within the fungus or within the lichen thallus, you have this algae, either making a layer, a zone and living, or uniformly spread. So these 90% of the lichen thallus is made up of fungus and only 10% is of the photosynthetic partner. And it is believed that 1/5 of these fungal species, they are lichenized. That is why these lichens are treated under the fungal kingdom. And then when I say different types of organisms are involved, so it is about 98.9% is ascomycetous fungi are involved. Only less than 1% is of basidiomycetous fungi, and less than that is of the deuteromycetous fungi. Among photosynthetic partners, about 90% is green algae and only 10% are cyanobacteria involved. When I say this is a symbiotic association, so naturally the question comes, what is the relationship between these two partners, fungus and the algae? So if you go back, these lichens are studied from long back. So since 1753 or so, these lichens are studied by the period of Carl Linnaeus. And only in 1867, this Swedenegger, Simon Swedenegger, a Swiss botanist, he could demonstrate that lichens are actually made of two organisms. And naturally the question started, what kind of relationship these two organisms has? And some people say it's a parasitism. This fungus, being a dominant organism, has parasitized the algae. But what happens in case of parasitism? Ultimately, the host has to die. And if the host dies, this parasite also will die, parasite also dies. But in case of lichens, it doesn't happen. So once the lichen thallus is established, it will remain there for a long period. So then people started proposing it as the controlled or the balanced parasitism. Okay, where fungus is dominating, but it is not allowing the algae to flourish, multiplying its number, huge number, and also it is not allowing it to die. This is a controlled parasitism. Some people said it is the endosaprophytism. These lichens, these fungus are saprophytes. So when they saw inside the thallus, they saw some dead algal cells. That is why people thought it is a endosaprophytism. It algae, this fungi may be depending on the dead algal cells. They thought like that. So some people said it is a helotism or master and slave relation. Master is fungus, slave is algae. Some people say it is a mutualism. Mutualism where both the partners are benefited. So here in case of lichens, fungus gives a shelter to algae. Fungus also absorbs the nutrients and the moisture and supply to the algae. Algae in turn synthesizes carbohydrate through photosynthesis and using the sunlight. It synthesizes the carbohydrates and supplies to the fungus and also it utilizes for itself. So that is why they thought symbiosis, the mutualism. But whatever may be the relationship, so we simply call the relationship between these two organisms as the symbiosis. Okay, that is worldwide accepted. Lichens are nothing but symbiotic relationship between fungus and a photosynthetic partner. And there are different names for the lichens. So in English itself, they are called as oak moss, island moss, reindeer moss, rock moss, stone flower. And this stone flower is common in most of the languages. For example, in Kannada, it is called as kalluhu. That is simply the translation of stone flower. In Hindi also, it is called as patthar ka phool. And if you go to Konkani in Marathi language, they are called dagad phool. All the meanings are same. And in Sanskrit, it is called as shilapush, shailya, yes, sifal. And then Tamil also, it's kalpasi, kaltamara, kaljadai. Same meaning. Bengali, it is called as shailja. Himachali, mehendi. Kashmiri, it is called as pumrose. Punjabi name is very interesting. It is called chalchabila. Assam, it is called as jau. And if you go to Uttarakhand, it is called as chadila or julagas. And also, we have derived a scientific name or technical term for Hindi, this lichens in Hindi. For example, it is called as shaik. Here it is taken from two words, shaival. Shaival is for algae and kavak is for fungus. And the first letter of two words, shai and ka, it makes shaik. So these are the different names of for the lichens in various language. And how do the lichens look? Simply, for a layman, lichens looks like fungus. If you go and see on the tree, the white patches what you see may be a lichen. But if it has a fine margin, wavy margin, and if the thallus is smooth, then certainly it is a lichen. And the experts identify lichens only with their experience or bringing you to the laboratory, they will see whether algae is there or not. They will be having other equipment like hand lens and all. They will identify whether it is lichens or fungus. Otherwise, there are different categories for the lichens. The basic three categories are crustose, folios and fruticose. The crustose lichens are crust-like. They are very closely attached to the substratum. You cannot remove them. If you want to remove them, you have to remove them along with the bark or the rock on which they are growing. So they are crustose lichen. And some are folios lichens. Folios have the loose leafy margin. If you try, sometimes you can remove them from the substratum. They have the dorsiventral differentiation. If you try, you can remove them from the substratum. There are some lichens which are called as fruticose, which are bush-like, which are attached to the substratum at one point and remaining part is hanging or erect. These are the three basic categories of the lichens. And lichens are very colorful. They may appear as white, they may be off-white, gray, yellow. There are some beautiful lichens like orange, bright yellow. If you go to Himalayas and all, you will see very beautiful orange colors of lichens. They are called as Xanthoria or Calloplaca. And there are some lichens which are beautifully yellow in color, fluorescent yellow. They may be rhizocarpon. Okay, so lichens are very beautiful. So where do they grow? Lichens grow on all kinds of substratum. Lichens can grow on soil, they can grow on tree bark, they can grow on twigs, they can grow on leaf surface also, evergreen leaf. They will also grow on the rock surface, even on the man-made substrates or man-made artifacts such as plastic and the metal. Lichens can also grow on bones, human skull, and nets, glass, metal surfaces, as I told you. They can grow on the tiles, they can grow on the potters, pots and all. So lichens can grow on all kinds of substratum. And also these lichens can grow everywhere. They can grow on cold deserts like Antarctica or Leh or Ladakh. They can grow on the hot deserts like Sahara. They can grow on the tropical forest. They can grow on the temperate forest. So everywhere lichens can grow. So they have a wide range of habitat preferences. So these lichens have the beautiful lifestyle. These lichens are very fascinating organisms. Every aspect of the lichens are interesting. So that is why it is very basic, it is very interesting, or it is very much necessary to understand what are lichens. So I hope you people have enjoyed this video. If you like it, please click like and also subscribe our channel Lichens of India. Thank you very much.